Good day from Chem Help ASAP. Let's talk about resonance and amides, and this is a little bit more complex example and shows some of the layers that we have to consider when we talk about acidity of compounds. So we have two acid-base reactions on the screen. One involves this amine, simple amine as a functional group, and the other involves deprotonation of an amide. In both cases, we use this generic B with a lone pair instead of water as our base. And we form our conjugate bases, as always. And in both cases, our bases have an N minus. The top structure is an N minus, and the bottom it's an N minus. So both conjugate bases have the same atom bearing the charge. It has nitrogens have the same size. They have the same electronegativity. However, the pKa's are very different. The amine has a pKa of around 35, and the amide has a pKa of about 15. So big differences, and we're going to explain this through resonance, no surprise. So if we look in the bottom of the screen, bottom left, that's our model, our template for resonance. So we need to have a double bond or more specifically a pi bond next to an atom with a lone pair, and that's exactly what we have in the conjugate base of our amide, and I've redrawn it at the bottom of the screen. So we have a double bond between the carbon and the oxygen and a single bond to this nitrogen with a lone pair. So we're going to apply our resonance. So we're going to take our lone pair on nitrogen, and we're going to make a new carbon-nitrogen bond, and that will break this carbon-oxygen bond. And here is our additional resonance form based on our arrows. Now we're going to have a negative charge on oxygen. One thing I want to point out is here is our arrow that indicates we're showing resonance form. It forms. It's this line with arrows on both ends. That's different from our equilibrium arrow. So there is a distinction, and you're communicating different things when you use these different types of arrows. So here we have this new conjugate base, and now we've drawn two Lewis representations of this same structure, of the same anion. Which one is better? Well, one has an N minus and one has an O minus. Both of them have full octets. That's the number one rule for Lewis structures. But O minus is more stable than N minus. And why is that? Well, because oxygen's more electronegative. It can handle that negative charge better. So we would say that this is the major contributor. And over here on the left, which is the original conjugate base we drew, this is the minor contributor. So through resonance, yes, we can delocalize this charge. It's shared between the oxygen and the nitrogen. But what's the real reason that amides are more acidic than amines? Amides are more acidic because when we draw the resonance form, we see that we can put the charge on a more electronegative atom. So resonance is a factor, yes, but this is really, as we consider the resonance forms, it's an electronegativity issue. The negative charge is on the more electronegative atom. Now, we had to look at resonance to get to that conclusion, but this is really an electronegative atom situation. So why are amides more acidic than amines? It's an electronegativity issue. But resonance allows us to visualize or access that answer. So this gets pretty complicated because sometimes multiple factors are at play, but we have to narrow it down to what's the most important thing. Really, this is the resonance form that explains the stability of this particular conjugate base, and it's because we have the negative charge on an oxygen instead of a nitrogen.